know where I come from. I say your touch is the reason I'm bamboo. I remember the day you won my heart. You tell me say you are God of everything, the God of land. Follow my way, as I follow your way, my life turn around. That's why I say I go bless your name every day of my life. In the midst of challenges, your blessings are bound. Miracles all around. Words can express how so happy I am.
Crazy world. So, we say a prayer.
Come on, just Cynthia Johnson?
Yes.
Okay, Cynthia Johnson. Yes, ma'am, what's her name?
Adebayo.
Stephanie? Oh, okay. Wow, so this happens to be your office, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, okay. All right, thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Have a good day, ma'am.
Thank you.
No!
For the past 15 years, and our audit is going to be going over five different categories. It's going to be church growth, leadership development, stewardship, accountability, and of course your missions and ministry.
We have given you sufficient time for you to prepare. I hope you are ready.
Yes, we are ready. Every necessary arrangement that we put in place, I'm sure we're going to do well. You are welcome.
Thank you. Can we have your company folders and your personnel folders?
Alright.
Thank the CEO, Mr. Peter, the manager, and every person here. You guys have really done a very good job. And as we mentioned earlier, we actually assessed this organization on the five main categories: church growth, leadership development, accountability, stewardship, missions, and ministry. I would like to begin with church growth. Looking around, looking at what we saw, there is actually church growth here. Yeah, there is moderate church growth, according to your records that we actually reviewed. There is moderate church growth over the years, and the numbers may not be impressive. We noticed that there are a lot of employees, you know, coming in and out, right? Mm-hmm. Okay, and considering the programs we have in place, you have a lot of programs to facilitate church growth. Like, we see that you have the monthly evangelism revival, special programs where you have invited a lot of people over the years to come and, you know, have programs in the church. We also notice that comparing the newcomers and the number of people we have in the church, that there's a very high turnover here. Looking at your newcomers record, comparing to the number of members you have in this organization, we realize that your retention rate is low, and that is something that you need to work on. We realize that you have teachings and various help to help the newcomers to stay. You have the newcomers class. You train your employees to work, but why are they not, you know, remaining in the organization? Sometimes, according to our record, you have actually put in a lot into some of your employees. You just employed. There's a lot of involvement in educating them, in training them, but the turnover is really very high, and there's nothing to show for.
We review your financial record, and we've impressed with the value you've invested in the leadership training and development over the year.
Yes, we actually congratulate you for what you've been doing, how you've been training your staff, but we realize that very few members of staff are taking advantage of this training, and it's very, very disappointing.
So at this point, we'd like to commend you on the readiness and the availability of staff to complete this assigned programs that are provided for the organization. However, during our site inspection, we found some employees who are not as committed as the rest. We found some poor stewards of these resources that you provide. It seems like a few individuals are not ready to take up this responsibility for the firm's success. Some are showing late, some are refusing to pay their tithes, some are even gossiping and sowing seeds of discord in the organization.
True. Nevertheless, you have all done a very remarkable work in missions and ministry. We see that you provide food for the community and there is accommodation for the homeless. We see how there is love in your midst, but we notice that a lot of you may be weary because probably you may have invested in someone or in a particular situation over the years, and because there was no reward, no real profit for it, a lot of you may have been weary. But let us not forget what our policy says, that we shouldn't be weary of doing good things, and that in due season we shall all reap a good reward. In conclusion, we see that you have all done amazingly over these last 15 years. We need you all to take note of your strengths, everything we have recommended as auditors to you. You have to take note of it, work on your weaknesses, strengthen your strengths, and do not be weary in doing well, knowing fully well that your reward is not from me or from the auditors. Your reward comes from God. And in the next 15 years, hopefully when we come back, all these recommendations would have been taken into action and we'll have a better audit. Thank you so much and happy anniversary.